That's the actual floor that we run up with. They wire tire up it all the embed in place. It is, you can see that lifting mechanism says 50 ton capacity. The D-Mag are going to be trying to lift it up and then they'll lower it into position. And then they'll take the formwork on the outside, slap them on both sides, attach it, and you're ready to pour. It's a lot more effective and safe.
You don't need to do that all the time. You know, you have to have all protection on and lifting mechanism.
So
this is really both more efficient and
the cost of them is the height of the weight, really, is a better view of it. Where the arches are there, wrapping the structure still, that's one of the few four caves where melters go. They would come in the truck, roll in, and go to about the middle of the facility. This facility has two melters, 98 metric tons, and they produce a special sense of glass per day. Whereas the law has two melters as well, but they're 300 metric tons, and they'll produce about 30 metric tons of glass per day. Same technology, just the scale. Are you seeing the weight? We have a huge chiller plant putting in the floor balancer in the area because of the temperature. Right now it's a chiller cooler system, which is an insulation of the right now it goes to the cooler facility, and then we have a cooling tower. So it's not used productively in the design right now. Yeah. So we have a chiller compressor putting in front of the chilled water that would cool the melted cake so we don't elevate temperature damage to concrete. And actually that's one of the challenges